Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Anime Theory, where I'm finally making that second Death Note video after promising it months ago in the first one. You guys seem to want more Death Note, so hopefully this will suffice. At least know I make another Death Note video sooner or later, but that's not important right now. Anyways, this theory will contain spoilers for the anime Death Note, so if you haven't watched it, I'd recommend you go do so before watching this video. Also, might as well say this because a lot of people have brought it up. Yes, I know Mikami didn't die in the manga. I don't do manga though, I do anime. This is anime theory, not manga theory. Sorry, that just got a little bit on my nerves the last video. Anyways, Death Note. Dude, this anime somehow feels like it's grown on me even more since I watched it. I have no clue why, but something about this show continued to draw me back. Maybe it's the story, the crazy situations, or perhaps it's the amazing cast of characters. Actually, bringing up those characters, they're kind of the focus of today's theory. Death Note's characters are quite unlike any other anime I've ever seen. They're all really out there, have huge issues, and have aspects not seen in most anime characters. Why is this, you ask? Well, Death Note's major characters all have some kind of big mental issue that defines them. Heck, in some cases they have multiple. It's this aspect that separates the characters from the perfect, borderline predictable casts of most anime. This is because, in essence, they are each flawed in a way that not only makes the show a lot more entertaining and interesting, but ironically enough brings them closer to humanity. They are each imperfect in some way, and this changed the whole plot in incremental ways. I just wanted to discuss some of these mental issues that the characters have, and honestly, it's because some of these aspects almost seem like they were meticulously created to represent the exact portrayal of each mental illness. I'll be discussing a couple of the physical issues as well because some of them are quite interesting. I'm more making this to see how they relate to real life though. Disclaimer before we start, I am not trying to tick people off who have mental illnesses. I am simply discussing some of the cool details from the anime. If you get offended, it's really only your fault. Also, I'll be covering the three main characters for a majority of the story, Misa, L, and of course Light. They're the ones that get the most screen time, so there's more details that the creators could fill in. Anyways, let's dig right into this theory and figure out what each character has. So, first let's start with the third, second, and best detective, L. One look at this guy and you pretty much know something's pretty off about him. I mean, I love him, but this is not a face I'd want to wake up to in the middle of the night. Anyways, first let's start with some of the physical defects. As a warm-up before we discuss his mental state, of course. To start with, you ever looked at this guy's hands? In any scene where he's holding a phone or something, he holds it in a bizarre way. His fingers are strangely long as well, and they're also kind of a bit deformed. Well, interestingly enough, this isn't just an animation quirk. It's likely that L has Marfan syndrome, otherwise known as spidery hands. It's a defect that a person can have where their fingers are much longer than a normal human hand. Sometimes the fingers can get absurdly long, but L here doesn't seem to have it as bad. Good thing is that this defect doesn't cause any serious issues, so L is fine, at least for right now. What isn't quite as fine is his likely scoliosis problem. To be completely fair, I'm not 100% sure, but whenever he's shown, his back is in an arc. Doesn't matter if he's standing, sitting, or whatever, his back always seems to be arced in a strange way. Scoliosis is a case where the spine is curved in a strange way, often forming a C or S shape. Unlike Marfan syndrome, however, L seems to have some pretty severe scoliosis. Don't worry though, L. It won't kill you or anything. Though you may want to worry about those Shinigami though. Now on to the mental issues. Well, let's look at some of L's more defining traits. Firstly, L is well known for his borderline obsession with habitual rituals. He's determined to sit in a crouching way because it seems that he assumes that he functions better like that. He's prone to constantly eating sweets, almost never being seen without some kind of snack. He habitually bites his nails, seems to get little sleep, and when becomes focused on something, he almost never gives up on it. He was so focused on solving the Kira case that he basically disregarded everything else, including his actual health. He's also shown to be quite terrible with social skills, seeming to have a serious trouble conversing with other people in a normal way. He even admits to Light at some point that Light was basically his first friend, and that's pretty sad. He's also mildly awkward, never knowing exactly how to respond to things. If these things sound familiar, it's because they're all symptoms of Asperger's syndrome. Literally every aspect of his character seems to build off of this, and it's interesting to see how mental illness was portrayed in this way. They could have done it terribly, but the creators actually made L an awesome character, and arguably the best and most interesting character as well. You see, guys, not every character needs to be the representation of perfect to be interesting. Honestly, L feels far more real than most high school anime characters, which is equal parts interesting and kinda scary. Anyways, enough about spirit animals, let's move on to Misa. Now, her issue is a bit simpler than the other characters. Undoubtedly, Misa has a case of ADHD. She's extremely impulsive, especially when first being introduced, where she basically makes all of her choices on the fly. She even decides that she needs to meet Kira long before having the capability to do so, and ends up making the Shinigami Eye deal before thinking it through. She also seems to suffer from chronic boredom several times, and lacks any clear focus. She just sort of does things without thinking them through. It's pretty much dead set that Misa has ADHD, which is a pretty good explanation for why her character is the way it is. Finally, let's move on to the main character, and the one with the craziest amount of detail put into him. Now, I know what you're thinking. What mental illness does Light have? Isn't he just a psychopath? Well, actually, yes. That's exactly what he is. No, but wait, there's more to it than that. Most people seem to forget that there's a lot more that goes into being a psychopath. Not every villain who runs around murdering and plotting is a psycho. That is literally only around 10% of what it takes. And it just so happens that Light embodies the literal requirements to become an extreme level psychopath. You see, there's a special set of definitions for psychopathy, labeled under the triarchic model of psychopathy. And Light fits the bill for it in every way. Firstly, typically a psycho will lack any real fear of, well, anything. No challenge seems too daunting, no opponent too fierce, nothing seems to be an issue. Now how about you, Mr. I'm gonna become the god of the new world? Yeah, there's pretty much no fear in this guy, even at the end, honestly. Secondly, there's the inability to make any real connections with anybody. Psychopaths oftentimes have no true love or attachment to anyone, and will often go out of their way to seclude themselves. Well, just to start with, none of Light's friends are actually even his real friends. Heck, most of the show, he just uses them to get what he wants. His family seems completely unimportant to him in a lot of ways. I mean, he has some sort of empathy for him, but not really anything significant. Even his girlfriend, Misa, is more of a tool to him than anything. He could literally care less if he walked outside one day and she was run over by a car. He only cares about himself, and that's it. Thirdly, psychopaths will occasionally make brash decisions when things get bad. Light was a little better than most, but even he would make some huge leaps of faith in order to win, and would occasionally act without really thinking. That's how L managed to figure out where Kira was in one try, and that's what happened at the end of the series. Sure, sometimes he's level-headed, but other times he just does whatever he feels like, to varying degrees of success. Light is also manipulative, and kind of a jerk, and honestly, he could care less about the thousands of deaths he's caused, whether innocent or guilty. But that's aside because he has another interesting parallel as well. In essence, just like most psychopaths, Light has a completely fake personality that he uses as a mask to hide his true identity. In most documented cases, psychopaths often seem normal and even charming upon the first meeting. It isn't until a decent amount of time is spent where someone can finally begin to see the real face from beneath the mask. His identity as Light is pretty much a mask for Kira to wear to fool people. As seen by the end of the series, however, this mask begins to crack and even some of the people he works with begin to see the real man underneath. So yes, Light is a psycho, but now if anybody ever tells you he's not, you can bring this evidence to the table and tell them that they're completely wrong. Some also like to claim that he has a god complex. I mean, it's true, but it's also not a mental illness. A god complex isn't a real mental disorder, and in fact, the term originates from fictional media. So yes, he totally has a god complex, it's just not a mental condition. Still interesting to note though. Anyways, Death Note has so many interesting layers to it, and these mental illnesses are only one chunk of it. If you put in a perfectly normal set of characters from any other anime, the whole show would likely be a whole lot less interesting. It's these issues that strengthen them as characters, and that make them a whole lot closer to real life than most other anime protagonists could ever hope to be. Also, kudos to the creators of the series. They clearly put a lot of time and effort into these characters in an effort to humanize them. Unless it was all unintentional, but I kind of doubt that honestly. It just doesn't seem possible if they didn't do this on purpose. Anyways, you may be wondering what those other layers I mentioned were. Well, don't worry, I'm planning another Death Note video sooner or later that will expand on the stuff mentioned here, and go into some of the other amazing things. Until then, just remember that L is both best girl and best spirit animal. Oh, nope. I guess according to Crunchyroll Awards, the best spirit animal is Yuri on Ice. Of course. Hey everybody, I've got some cool fan art to show off. First, there's this art from Kyoko Momo, which happens to be me with Sayaka, who, if you didn't know, I claimed a little while ago, and she's now mine. And this art is really adorable, it's amazing. I liked it so much, I put it as my Twitter profile, and I really like it. It's really great. In fact, more fan art like this, I definitely appreciate. Also, there's this really adorable art by Samarani, it's just a space. And man, it's just way too cute looking. Like, seriously, look at this. I don't know how to explain it. I just like really adorable art. It just makes me feel really nice. And it's really great. Thank you for the art. And hey, if you have any fan art to send it to me through my Twitter, and I'm going to show it off in a video. Because fan art is basically the best thing ever. Hey everybody, if you like this video, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I mean, hey, why don't you watch some of my other videos? They're pretty cool. Why don't you check out my second channel, Duo Animates, at least for the moment being. It's probably going to be Duo Stuff soon, because I'm going to kind of change what the channel is. I want to do some more focused on YouTube content. I think it would be pretty cool. I've got some cool video ideas, so check that out. Subscribe to it. Get ready for the cool content. And hey, check out my Twitter. It's pretty cool. And I've got a lot of videos planned, like a ridiculous amount of videos. Some of them are collabs, some of them aren't. It's going to be pretty cool, so I hope you're looking forward to those. And there's not really much else to say besides see you later.